Hi friends! In this video, I'm going to show you step by step how I made the CNC laser engraver. For this project, I use parts from DVD players, which are not used much nowadays. I also use an Arduino Uno among other components. In this video, we will see a design and 3D printing, the circuit, the final assembly, and the excellent results I got. I invite you to watch the whole video as I found it very interesting and entertaining. I know you will like it. Let's start. To start with this project, we are going to bring two readers that we no longer use. In my case, I have this one that I both used at a good price. We unscrew the four screws of the metal cover, and now we uncover it to access the circuits and the mechanism inside. Now, I am going to disconnect the wires that are connected to the most exposed board, and remove it effortlessly by pushing the plastic hook that holds the board. Now, we are going to remove the motor. To do this, we unscrew its two screws and remove it easily. This is a stepper motor that has a built-in spindle that will give linear movement to the X and Y axis. With the help of a pair of pliers, I remove the spring that is in the white plastic piece. This is the spring that we remove, and we will use it later. Now, we remove the metal rod, and screw one of the screws and slide it to the side, and here it is. In my case, I only got one rod from this drive, but other DVD drives have two rods. In total, we have to extract two stepper motors, two springs, four rods, and a few screws. This is the 3D design of the parts we will use for this CNC. I use Ultimaker Cura to do the lamination of the parts and generate the G-code. So, we are going to print it. I'm using white PLA filament for all the parts. These are the parts already printed. They have a nice finish and detail. To start with the assembly, I'm going to screw a stepper motor on the top of this U-shaped piece. We can use the line mark on the piece to position the motor as straight as possible. We are going to insert a spring in this piece, which is going to slide and put some pressure on the spindle or screw of the motor. Now, we are going to use two rods. I'm going to put one through the right hat column. Now, this piece, which is the block of the linear rail, we are going to pass it through the rod with the other rod. Now, we have the first motorized linear axis. For safety reasons, I'm going to put two covers on it, so that the rods don't slide to the sides. We can see that it slides without any problem and without much effort. Now, I am going to cut some thin wires and solder them to the pins of the stepper motor. The pins are already soldered, and I am going to run the wires through the compartment that they have all the way down the column to the bottom. As you can see, at the end, I am going to make a bend in the wire. I am going to insert this piece that has about 2 teeth into the corresponding space on the main piece, as you can see in the video. And we can add some instant glue. In the same way, we are going to place a spring with the help of the pieces, and it will be ready. Now, we are going to work with the base piece for the Y axis. First, I'm going to solder some wires to the stepper motor. I'm going to position the motor on the back of the base, using the line as a guide and screw it in. Now we have the two main bodies. I'm going to pass the U-shaped piece through the base piece. As you can see in the video, the teeth have to fit perfectly on the Y-axis spindle. I'm going to pass the rods through the two pieces, as they serve as guide or rails for the Y-axis. Finally, I insert the respective covers. The atlas and the frame are now ready for the mechanism. Now, I'm going to use this platform that I printed an Arduino Uno. I place the Arduino and screw it to the platform with some screws from the DVD player. This is an Arduino CNC shield that we can control up to 3 stepper motors independently. And we are going to insert it into the Arduino. And what you are looking at is a 4980 stepper motor driver. And we are going to insert 2 of these into the top of the shield. We are going to insert the component tower through the rails that have the base. To do this, first we are going to pass the cables through the gaps in the platform as shown in the video by pushing the sideways, and we will arrange the cables so that they are as loose as possible. There is a step division mode in this shield. To activate this mode, we have to place some jumpers. In total, we will use 6 of these jumpers. We can also make them in a homemade way using sprats and solder them together. This step can be done at the beginning. Finally, we will reinstall the drivers in the sockets. Now we are going to cut the terminals of the stepper motor wires and solder them to the 4-pin spade sockets that I prepared previously. As you can see, we connect the motors to the shield right next to the drivers. If it's connected the wrong way around, no problem because we will fix it later. To power the motors, we have this blue screw terminal. In my case, I'm going to use an 11-volt battery, but you can also connect a transformer or power supply. I'm going to connect some jumpers to a terminal, but I'm still going to connect the battery. This is the circuit of the project that we can be guided by. What we are going to do now is the laser power supply circuit. I will use this MOSFET transistor YRFC44N. To avoid damaging the laser wires, I'm going to use this JST connector. I'm going to drop a shim on the transistor and also a jumper to connect it later to the shield. I'm going to glue the transistor to one of the sides of the base. I finish soldering the wires and I fix it. This is the laser module we will use. This is a high power red dot and the focus of the laser diode is adjustable. We are going to put it on the stand that we printed. It fits perfectly. I'm going to insert the laser module into the slider. As we are looking at it, we finished making the CNC. That's the mechanism, the hardware, and the assembly. Now, I'm going to connect the Arduino to my laptop to be able to control the CNC. Here inside, we are going to open the BenBots application that you can download in the description of the video. This is the interface, and as you can see, it's pretty intuitive. The first thing we are going to do is to go into the configuration with the lightning bolt. We are going to select the COM port that is connected to our Arduino. We select the type of Arduino we are using, in my case, Arduino Uno. Now, we click on the yellow button. Select the LX Maker BenBot top heads, and click on check. We are going to click on the icon of the 3 stripes that is in the corner. There, we are going to set these parameters as shown in the video, but we can change them depending on the material we want to print and how we want to engrave it. In the section on the right, these are the values that have to be there. At the top are the numbers of each pinner stepped motor. Once we have verified all the values, we click on check. In the upper area, we have these arrows that are used to move the laser of the CNC manually. If the laser moves to the left side when we indicate the opposite, we can exchange these values of the X axis. The same can be done with the Y axis. We are going to connect the battery or 11 volt power supply that fits the motors. In the folder icon, we are going to select an image. As you can see, I am adjusting it so that it fits in a square of 4 cm of size. Now, press play and start printing. This mini laser engraver has a compact design, in my opinion somewhat minimalist. Remember that all the information and files for this open source project are in the description. Like this one if you like it, subscribe and activate the notification bell so you don't miss any video. Well friends, that's all and see you in the next project.